Well, it is our esteemed pleasure to get to talk to you, Mr. Tomohiko Ishii. Sir, it's a great pleasure to finally talk to you on camera. I just want to ask you about some of your experiences with producing and some of the things you've worked on. So tell us, what was it like getting into the business?
こういうプロデューサーという仕事を始めたきっかけっていうのは何でしたか。僕は
1999年にスタジオジブリというスタジオに入って、で そこのプレジデントの鈴木敏夫さんという人のアシスタントになりました。
So in 1999 I was able to join Studio Ghibli and I worked as the assistant to producer Suzuki Toshio.
Wow.
で宮崎駿監督と高畑勲監督の、まあ、作品のプロデュースの、まあ、アシスタントをするわけですけど、まあ、当然いろんな仕事の全てを下で見て、でもうひたすらデッチ暴行、もうひたすら走り回ってそれをお手伝いするので、まあ、それをしながらプロデューサーというのはどういう仕事をするのかということをまあ見て、で覚えたという感じですね。
So, you know, obviously being in Studio Ghibli, I worked with director Miyazaki and director Isao Takahata. And, you know, working for those two gentlemen, I was involved with so many different works and I was pretty much sent as a runner and I was made to do a lot of work that required me to keep going back and forth and doing many different things, kind of seeing many different parts.
Oh, cool. So you had a very busy time as a producer.
大変忙しかったでしょうか。
鈴木さんが、僕が21歳の時に、最初に言っておきたいことがあると。寝るなって言われたんですね。
So when I was 21, Mr. Suzuki had some advice for me. He said, there's one thing I want to tell you. Don't sleep.
で20代のうちに寝なければ30代40代50代60代死ぬまで寝ないで済むから。
And he said, you know, as long as you don't sleep in your 20s, you won't need to sleep in your 30s, 40s, 50s or 60s.
Makes sense.
That's very good advice.
Okay, that actually makes sense. Yeah.
彼は今62歳なんだけど未だに寝ないですね。
So he's, you know, currently he's 62 years old and he still doesn't sleep.
He'll catch up to it at some point. Okay, so what has been some of your favorite work though?
一番好きな一番タイトルですかね。それとも
the work that he's worked with?
Yes,
that he's worked on?
Yes, what are some of your favorites that you worked on?
今まで関わってきた作品の中で個人的にこれが一番楽しかったなって思った作品。
まあ、2つありますね。で、1つはごめんなさい、3つあるかな。1つは宮崎駿監督と一緒にの下でやらせていただいたSpirited Away ですね。千と千の神隠しですね。
So I have three that I'd like to tell you about. One is Spirited Away.
Yes,
under director Miyazaki.
これはもう日本で一番ヒットしたし、ベルリン映画祭も取ったし、アカデミー賞も取ったという、いろんな意味でも歴史が日本の歴史が大きく変わる瞬間だったので。
So you know, obviously it won a Berlin Award and the Academy Award. It has a huge history and it was the most successful work in Japan.
で2つ目は押井守監督と一緒に作ったスカイクローラーズという作品で、これはまあ初めて僕がもう前の会社を辞めて一人で守押井ってものすごくその有名な方だったので、その人と一緒に全く一から作品を作ったということは、まあ、非常にチャレンジングだったんでしたね。
So after I left Ghibli and I started kind of off doing my own thing, I was able to work with director Mamoru Oshii.On Skycrawlers.
Yes.
And this is my first work to actually be involved with from the very, very, very beginning and do a complete work. So for me, it was a very interesting time.
Can you tell us more about that?
もう一つは神山健治監督と一緒に作った Eden of the East ですね、東のエデンという作品で、これはもう初めてのオリジナル作品だったことと、あとはその、まあ、作りながらこう起きてることと現実がすごくリンクしていて、例えば物語の第1話でその東京にミサイルが落ちるというところが始まるんですけど、放送の1日前にその北朝鮮からミサイルが飛んできて危うく放送が中止になったりとか、あとは主人公がその裸で登場するんですけど、日本で人気のアイドルが本当に裸で公園で登場したりとか、まあ、監督が描くことが次々とリアルに起こっていて、放送できないかもしれないとか、逆にそれがすごく話題になったりとかっていうことがあったので、まあ、なんか時代とアニメーションのリンクを感じた とてもその印象的な作品でした。
So probably the third work I'd like to tell you a little bit about was Eden of the East with, that I did with director Kamiyama. The first of all, that was first original work that I had worked on. And it was very interesting because in the story, even in the first episode, one of the kind of amazing things was director Kamiyama was almost able to predict the future in that in the first episode, a missile comes and strikes Japan. Well, in reality, the day before we were supposed to air the show, there was a real missile launch from North Korea toward Japan. And there was a lot of concern that maybe because of this real world event, we may not be able to air the show on TV.
Yeah.
Additionally, in the first episode, if you've seen it, there is a completely naked man. All right, the main character is completely naked and in front of the White House. What just so happens that in reality, in Japan too, there's a very famous band and a person in that group, okay, idol group if you were, was actually found completely stark naked in a park.
Oh, wow.
And so, again, it seemed that one thing after another, Director Kamiyama predicted the future. What he wrote in the anime came to life.
You should just, and then I got $10 billion, and you see what happens.
で、その次に、お金がたくさん入りましたって描けば、実際にお金が入ってくればよかったな。
そうですね、そうですね。そうすると、セカンドシーズンが作りやすくなります。
Yeah, had that happened, it would have been easier to make a second season.
Is there anything that you can tell us in particular about the new work you had a hand in, RE Cyborg?
Re-Cyborg?
Re-Cyborg, yeah.
009? じゃあちょっと009の話していただけませんか、
はいはい、あサイボーグ009というですね日本ですごく有名なその漫画原作の作品ですね
So Cyborg 009 is actually a really really famous historical manga in Japan、
right.
その漫画が書かれたのはもう30年以上前なんですけど
It's about 30 years old
Oh, wow.
今回僕らが作った作品はもう2012年のまさに現代が舞台となります。
So the setting in this version of Re-Cyborg is actually the year 2012.
で、オリジナルの漫画はその冷戦時代にそのいわゆる共産、まあ、ソ連ですね、ソビエトの、まあ、悪の科学者が戦争のために世界中からいろんな人を集めてきてサイボーグ化する。例えばロシア人だったりフランス人だったり当然アメリカ人もいるんですけどただ彼らがその悪の組織から逃げ出して正義のために戦うというのがオリジナルのストーリー
See, the original story was really set in kind of the Cold War era, you know, in a communist country in Russia, right? This group or organization, this evil organization gathered individuals from all over the world and basically turned them into cyborgs.And then he was going to use them as weapons to fight the rest of the world. But it just so turned out that these individual cyborgs were able to escape from this organization under their own will. And that's kind of how the 009 starts.
Okay. Was there any apprehension translating such a popular work into another medium? Do you have any fears about how that would be received?
歴史のある作品なので、それを、新たに自分たちでそのストーリーの続きを書くにあたって、何か遠慮してたところとか気にしてたところってありましたか？
そうですね。まず監督と話したのは、とにかく原作のファンにこれは009ではないって言われちゃうような作品にはしたくないけれども
Yeah, one of the things we talked about with the director is to make sure that when we do make this, we don't want the core fans of Cyborg 009 to look at our version and say, ah, that's not 009.
ただ、やっぱり見てほしいのは今の若い人も見てほしいので、その監督が考えたのが、その30年前の戦いがもう終わって、で、サイボーグたちがそれぞれも自分の国に帰って、それぞれ自分自身の仕事をしていると。例えばアメリカ人の002はアメリカの NSA に所属しているとか、主人公の009は記憶を失って高校生になって学生として暮らしている。この30年の間に時間が経過したということをきっちり作ってから、その現代を舞台に新たな敵と戦うというストーリーを作りました。
And so, you know, obviously, even though we didn't want to upset the old fans,At the same time, we wanted to make sure that it was the current younger generation that watches this. So the setting actually happens 30 years after, where all of the cyborgs had kind of decided to go their own way. And for example, 002 who's the American, he's a member of the NSA. And 009, he actually has his memories erased or lost, and he is a high school student in Japan. And so they created these settings to try to more relate to current day.
Well, at least a lot of people, a lot of directors, they don't really care about the it's going to be my vision. It's nice that you guys actually considered the fans in it before you went about this project.
So many fans のことを考えて作ったことなので、とても感謝してます。
ああ、ありがとうございます。特にもうサイボーグ009とサイボーグ009の作者である石森章太郎さんという人は、日本でいうと手塚治虫さんと石森章太郎さんというこの二人がもう神様のような。その人の作品を怪我してしまうのはもう絶対にしてはならないことです。
Yeah, so I mean, one of the things that was very important for us, obviously, is the original creator, his name is Shotaro Ishinomori, and in much like Osamu Tezuka, they're both considered kind of gods in the industry, and the last thing they wanted to do was create anything that would reflect poorly upon their reputation
as works.
Well, is there anything in your past work that maybe you would have done differently or changed or anything of that sort?
With the knowledge that you have now.
ああ、今の自分が振り返ってみると、昔関わってた作品、今まで関わってた作品で、何か違うやり方やればよかったなって思ってるところってあります？
東のエーデンは、公開のスケジュールが間に合わなくて延期しちゃったんですよね。
So in the East, right? We our schedule kind of slipped a little bit, right? We didn't really match the date we wanted to for opening.
もっといっぱいお金を集めておけばよかったですね。
So I kind of wish we'd done a better job, maybe gathering more resources to make that happen.
But overall, you're satisfied with your career as it stands right now.
まあ自分のキャリアとかには満足してますか？
あまり昔のことを考えずにこれからのことを考えるようにしてますね。
So I try not to spend too much time dwelling on my past, and I'm trying to look forward to go and continue to make great anime.
例えばその宮崎駿監督という人は一回作品を作ると自分の作品を絶対に見直さないんです。
So Miyazaki Hayao never looks back on his own works. Once he creates something, he doesn't turn back. He's probably not watched his own Nausicaa Valley of the Wind in over 30 years.
Wow. I guess that's a great philosophy to have.
So I think that type of philosophy, as you say, right, is probably very important when you're trying to continually create.
So with that in mind, do you have any future projects that you're excited about, or is there anything that you are aiming to do with your career in the future?
これから楽しみにしている自分が関わるような作品、
そうですね、
自分のキャリアに対して
なんかいくつか企画はあるんですけど、まだタイトルは詳しくは言えないんですけど、今回のサイボーグ009はキャラクターは全部 3D で制作しました。で、見た目はその手で描いたセルルックアニメーションに似てるんですけど、技術的には全て 3D で作ってます。で、これによってそのできる表現の幅というのがものすごく広がったので、まあ、いくつかある企画の中に必ずこの技術を投入して、これまで その手書きのアニメーションではできなかった表現をどんどんやっていきたいなと思っています。
Of course I have several multiple projects plans in the works. Nothing I can give a concrete name on right now. However, one thing I can tell you is one of the things we did with 009 was we used full 3D modeling and was able to use that technologyto create the anime. And I think if I could say one thing, it will be that with whatever future work and some future work, I want to make sure that I can continually leverage that same type of technology, full 3D modeling to cel shading. It still looks like a traditional anime, but it's cel shaded down from a 3D model. And that technology I thought was really good.
Okay. Well, awesome. That's all of the questions that we had. We hope you enjoy the rest of the con. We hope to catch some of your panel as well, just to learn a little bit more if we could.
ありがとうございます。質問はこれが以上なんですけど、これから多分明日でも明後日でもパネル見に行きますので。
Thank you.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
All right.